The following program contains material that may be too intense for some viewers. Parental discretion is advised.
Alone tonight? Well, consider yourself lucky. There could be two of you, and imagine what a frightmare that could be. Just a reflection. Not so for tonight's stars, Frank and Eddie, two brothers who are touchingly close. When a woman tries to come between them, she finds herself caught in a tangled web of jealousy and intrigue. I think you'll find it a twinning combination. So without further ado, I bring you my brother's keeper.
Well, go! You drive like an old lady. Have I ever told you that, Frank?
Whenever I try it, Eddie.
Which is all the time, isn't it, Frank?
Why even bother having a Ferrari when you're driving like a goddamn Volkswagen? You wanted a Ferrari, I would have been very happy with a Volkswagen.
You've been happy with a bicycle built for two. Now, look, if you don't step on it, I will.
Ah! Get your foot off me! Eddie, this isn't funny. We're going to have an accident. I can't stand being with you when you're like this.
Well, you don't have much choice, do you, Frank? Not unless you agree to see that new doctor I found.
Another doctor! Nobody's doctor! Enough! Stop!
Okay.
Eddie, don't you know by now that no doctor can help us with our problems?
Problem, Frank. We only have one problem. I gotta admit, it's a beaut.
Really, Eddie, you'd be so much happier if you just learned to accept our condition. Accept the fact that we're freaks. Never.
You're only a freak if you think you're a freak.
Oh, please, Frank. You're psycho bullshit. When your ass is attached to another guy's ass, you're a freak.
Bartender, give me a scotch, will you?
Eddie, remember, when you drink, I feel it too.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Make it a double.
So, what's going on here? Hey, you know, underneath that.
You looking at me?
Gee, I thought I was the only person weird enough to read books in bars.
Mine's Andre Malraux's Man's Hope.
Well, this certainly is fate. Isn't that funny? I'm Marie Hilton.
Frank Duran.
Well, looky here. You know, under that Marion the Librarian exterior, I'm thinking there's a studded leather corset just itching to get out, am I right?
Eddie!
Please. We were having a nice conversation.
Well, hey, don't let me cramp your style, little brother.
Is that guy your brother?
Yeah. I guess he got all the personality.
Well, if that's personality, he can have it all.
You know, Marie, you look familiar. I could swear we've met somewhere.
Well, I don't know. Do you ever go to the symphony?
I love the symphony.
Did you go last Sunday?
No, I couldn't convince my brother to go. Actually, that's why I agreed to come with him tonight. Three trips to a bar equal one symphony.
So you and your brother have to do everything together?
You see, Eddie and I
are... Come on, Frank, let's dance.
Eddie, please, I was just telling Marie...
Talk to her on the dance floor, come on.
You wouldn't want to.
I'd love to dance. Oh, my God. You're connected.
Oh, isn't that noticeable? Yeah, Marie, I've been meaning to tell you, Eddie and I are Siamese twins.
They're Siamese twins? Gross.
How about you? You ever tried a four-legged lobotomy?
Oh, Eddie, come on!
Listen, it's getting late, and I have to get up really early, so I have to go.
Still don't think you're a freak, Frank?
Extraordinary. Simply extraordinary. Not often does one come across a classic Pago-Pagi formation. Twins joined at the bottom.
Yeah, we know how we're attached. The question is, can we be separated?
Well, you both have the full complement of organs. You two are lucky that way.
Yeah, that we're lucky, Frank.
Of course, you share one single bloodstream. So this dense, entangled web of veins, arteries, would have to be completely rerouted.
The complication.
But not one that cannot be overcome. Today, with lasers, microsurgery, there is a chance.
There is a chance. Yeah, what kind of a chance?
Fumsish, fumsish. 50-50.
Oh, we'll take it.
Good.
Now, wait a minute, Eddie. There is a 50% chance we could die here.
No, Frank. There's a 50% chance we'd live.
I thought you and your brother were of one mind about this.
Oh, we are. We are.
Well, then, you must sign this medical release.
Come on. Sign it, Frank. It's not multiple choice.
I don't know, Eddie. I'm gonna need some more time to think about it.
When you are ready, the pen, I shall be ready with a knife.
You, thinking about the operation?
A little. You're not going to take a sleeping pill. I was planning to do some reading.
Story of our life, Frank. You zig and I zag.
You know, Frank, for most people, the simple act of pain does not have to be a synchronized Olympic event.
It's true.
Just think, Frank. Once we get the operation, you'll never have to go to another baseball game again.
Or Vegas.
With that hideous architecture. Oh, you could sleep in your own bed. I could roll over.
And that cooking school in Paris you always wanted to go to? The Cordon Rouge?
It's Cordon Bleu.
Blue Rouge. Whatever. The point is, you could go.
I could learn how to make that salmon en croûte with a champagne sauce.
Frank, you can do whatever you want once we are free.
All you gotta do is sign it, Frank.
Just sign it.
The operation is too risky.
Look, you signed that release. I'm giving you the operation right here. Sign it.
Eddie, I'm afraid.
Afraid of what? It'll work when we separated forever.
Well, maybe that's what I'm afraid of. Maybe I'm afraid that once we're separated forever, that I would be lonely.
Lonely? You goddamn pussy.
Hello?
Hello, Frank. This is Marie from the bar. Do you remember me?
Yes, of course I remember you, Marie.
I wanted to apologize for my behavior the other night. And, well, if you're willing to give me another chance, I'd like to see you again.
Marie wants to see me. We'll ask if she's had a blood test.
I beg your pardon?
A guest. My brother
asked if you would like to be our guest.
Eddie?
Yes?
What are you doing on Friday?
Well, I'm doing whatever you're doing, aren't I, Frank?
Problem, Frank?
A problem? Yes, I've got a problem. You haven't showered in a week. You smell like a compost heap. You know, I don't care if you shave, but will you please wash before we go out tonight?
Tell you what, Frank. I'll wash while you sign. You get ready. You, I, and Marie are going to the symphony. All right, Frank. Symphony it is.
Hey, sticky buns.
You know, under that distinguished patron of the arts exterior, I'm thinking there's a studded leather course just ditching to get off.
A toast to the chef.
Thank you.
Frank, I just can't believe you made all this wonderful food yourself, even a chocolate souffle.
Oh, souffles are quite easy, Marie. It's simply a matter of separating the egg whites.
Oh, but this is delicious, really.
More?
Oh, no, I couldn't possibly.
A smidge.
Well, maybe just a teensy-eensy smidge.
Hey, don't I get a teensy-eensy smidge?
Would you like some
no,
more?
No, I'd like a little more of that, of course.
Now, where were we?
Egg whites.
Egg whites.
Frank, are you okay?
Sorry, it's just that when Eddie drinks, I get drunk, too.
Boy, oh, boy. First time that schmuck gets a beautiful woman up here. He does impression of Julia Childs.
Eddie, I happen to find your brother's company stimulating.
Not really. More stimulating than, let's say, a tank of nitrous oxide and a 12-inch vibrator. Because that's the kind of party I throw, babe.
You'll have to excuse Eddie. He's being a bad boy.
Well, actually, it's getting really late. I should be going anyway.
Oh, I'll see you to the door. Oh, we'll both see you to the door.
Thanks, Frank. Thanks for a wonderful evening.
I'd offer to. I'd offer to drive you home, but I'm not in any condition.
Oh, sure, that's okay.
I hope you understand.
Night.
Au revoir, Marie.
Au revoir.
I know you tried to ruin it for me, but you didn't.
I'm happy. And you know why? Because I'm in love. Yeah, I know. You fall in love and I get a boner.
You know, Marie, these past few weeks have been the happiest of my life.
Oh, Frank. And you know how I feel about you, too.
What I suggest you do is what I always do in this situation. Just let your mind go completely blank.
Well, I don't know if I can, Frank.
I should probably be on bended knee for this, but,
Whoa, I'm a naughty boy!
Will you, would you... Will you marry me?
Oh, Frank, I'm sorry, but...
Marie!
It's too bizarre.
Marie!
I better go see about that girl. Stay there. You too.
Whoa! I am warning you, Eddie. You get off my back.
I'd love to, Frankie boy, but you're afraid of being lonely.
Hey, Miss Thing. Eddie says you're doing a real good job. You got his brother Frank right where he wants him.
No shit.
But see, you gotta turn up the heat now, baby. You gotta pump up the jam.
Pump it up, right.
Mm-hmm. Pump up the jam. Because Eddie says that if you get his brother to sign some paper by tonight, girlfriend, we don't have to be hoeing these streets no more.
Well, let's get it over with.
All right.
Frank, we have to talk.
Look, I don't blame you for being upset, Marie, but it won't always be like this, I promise you.
Frank, I want to believe you, but... What kind of future can we have with him with us all the time?
Give us one more chance. I love you.
I love you too, Frank. But
Marie, please, just give me one more chance.
It just couldn't work this way, Frank. It's not like there's anything you could do about it. But the way things are, I'm sorry. I don't know what else to say, Frank, but... Goodbye.
Marie. Give me the key.
Where did I put that key?
Marie, wait! Give me the goddamn key, Eddie!
Key. Oh, here it is, Frank.
Come on. Marie! Now get up!
No! You son of a bitch. You ruined my one chance at happiness.
Just a cuss from you, Frank? How uncivilized. You disgust me.
Good.
I hate you.
Now you're ducking.
I can't live like this anymore.
What are you gonna do about it?
I'm gonna...
You know what?
I'm gonna...
You know what, Frank?
I'm gonna sign Dr. Snellkraut's release form.
Well, it's about fucking time.
Frank?
Came back.
Don't sign that release, Frank.
Shut up, Marie.
How do you know about the release?
It was all a setup. Eddie hired me to help convince you to have that operation.
I'm warning you, Marie. So you never really cared about me?
Well, I wasn't supposed to, but I fell in love with you, Frank.
You did.
I mean, I don't know if you can forgive me, but if that proposal still stands...
Oh, it does.
Oh, okay.
It does.
I'll marry you, Frank, just the way you are. I don't want you to have that operation. It's is too risky. I don't want to lose you.
Oh, Marie. We'll build a little house for the three of us. How do you feel about kids?
Now, I'll never get rid of them.
Darling, I felt you stiffen. Am I rushing things?
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What did you do?
Double-crossing bitch wouldn't keep her mouth shut, Frank.
I'll call for help. I'll call the police.
Allow me, Frank. Looks like you got your hands full.
Hello, 911? Yeah, this is Edward Duran. I just killed my brother's fiancée with a cleaver. No, the name's Duran. I used the cleaver. Yeah. Oh, sure, I'll hold.
You're gonna pay for this, Eddie!
I was the dreamer, huh, Frank? Well, if they sentence me to the gas chamber, they'll never be able to carry it out. Think about it, Frank. If they kill me, they kill you. Now, that's cruel and unusual punishment.
Yeah, am I sure she's dead?
Yeah, she's definitely dead.
You're a monster, Eddie.
Yeah, but I'm your monster, Frankie boy. Forever.
Okay, we'll be waiting. Hey, what's this?
Frank, I'm not going anywhere. Whoa!
Hey, what are you doing? Frank, what are you doing?
I'm having a little midnight snack.
Hey, you're taking so many little pills!
Am I? I'm kind of a novice at this.
Come on, Frank. Don't fool around. Shouldn't mix booze with pills.
I thought you liked to live dangerously, Eddie. Ever since we were kids, I've had to put up with you being a bad one. Make excuses for you. Clean up after you. Apologize for you. Well, that's a lot.
A responsibility. Having to be the good one all the time.
Frank! You're gone. Killing us.
I can't live attached to a murderer.
Hospital, Eddie.
Oh, typical Frank. You try to kill me and all you do is give me a hell of a hangover. Sweetheart, give me a Bloody Mary, will you? I get a double.
Well, Mr. Duran, looks like you're well enough for visitors.
Edward Duran, you're under arrest for the murder of Marie Hilton.
Marie Hilton, that's right. Jeez, I did kill her, didn't I?
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to talk to a lawyer.
I guess Detective Potato Head here hasn't done his homework. I mean, there's really nothing he can do, seeing as how we're freaks.
We're not freaks, Eddie. We're free.
Or at least, I am.
Hey, you're over there!
Oh, did I forget to mention? I signed Dr. Schnellkraut's release form. He did a pretty good job, don't you think?
No! Don't let him take me away from you, Frank!
They're gonna put me in a car! Oh, what's come over you, big brother? You're acting like a goddamn pussy.
They're gonna put me in the gas chamber!
But don't worry, I'll be doing the living for both of us, Eddie boy. Ooh, nurse. You know, under that crisp white uniform, I'm thinking there's a studded leather corset just itching to come out. Am I right?
maggot meisters. How's that for a cheeky little tale? Frank Shaw picked a deadly time to sever all thighs with his brother, and poor Eddie suffered the unkindest cut of all. A real split personality.